Hello all, I am Suvarna Patil, working as Assistant Professor in D.Y. Patil Institute of Engineering Management and Research. So today I am going to present week 3 and 4 video under International FDP on Environmental and Sustainability. So my topic from first video was green networking. So how I have selected this green networking for environmental and sustainability. So already I have explained what is green networking in first video. So the first video was uploaded, and the brief idea of the first video was greening of the networking technologies and protocols and optimize the networking or make it more efficient. So it will automatically reduce the energy consumption and it conserve the bandwidth. And in second week video, I have tried to elaborate some standards of the green network. So the vision of the green network is one where we all can have a thin clients using low energy consumption and connected via wireless to the internet, where all our data is securely stored in highly efficient, reliable data centers, typically running at low energy per gigabyte per second speed. So it will automatically reduce the CO2 emission. So in that we have seen the different standards. So what is the video outcome? So after learning through all this video, the student will be enabled. So how it is possible that reduction of energy consumption can be achieved efficiently using green networking. So that can be achieved by improving the energy efficiency. Also, the student will able to correlate the environmental impact of network components from design to up to the end of that use of that network component. Also, making the network more intelligent as the intelligent network will be more responsive and it will require the less power to operate. And the fourth outcome is the promotion of cultural shift in the thinking about how we can reduce the carbon emission. So in video 3, I have explained the different green network standards. So the green network standards are Energy Star Rating, Green Grid, ISO 14000, then EPEAT and Climate Service. All these actually, these are used in household appliances or data center efficiency, environmental auditing, environmental labeling, or some desktop computers also. So apart from this, so in this video, I'm going to explain about the carbon emission. So as my topic is the networking, so in network, the data is transmitted over the network. So the traffic is to be considered. So this is the graph shown for the carbon footprint and the traffic within a network. So you can see from 2000 to 2020. So traffic can be increased. So the traffic can be increased up to the 2000, above the 2500 terabytes. So, but the CO2 emission for that is, you can see that it is decreasing. It is increasing at some level up to the 2015. Then after that, it is in the decreasing mode because we are adapting the various ICT technologies to reduce the carbon emission, and that carbon footprint calculation, many researchers are working on that carbon footprint calculation of the networking so that it can be reduced to some extent. So these are some graphs that are showing the carbon emission footprint. So the first graph, it is showing the ICT carbon footprint calculation. So in that, ICT may include the PCs, telecom networks, devices, printers, and data centers. The second graph, it is giving the more idea about the telecom infrastructure, also the data centers and the PCs. So the how we can see that carbon emission is increasing, but by working on the carbon footprint calculation, we can reduce it to some extent. So this is about the detail of the how the carbon footprint calculated for the different pieces. So in 2002, so instead of laptops were there, but they were in very less quantity, but the desktop were used in large volume. But in 2020, that is the no desktop computers, almost no desktop computers are used. So the carbon emission in case of in 2002, so that desktop computers were more, but in 2020 it has been reduced to some extent, very much to less extent. Then after that, this is the carbon footprint for the data centers. Means in data centers, the various servers, cooling systems, power system, mid-range servers, storage system, and high-end servers, all these are taken into consideration. So you can see the situation in 2002. So it was distributed, but in it was distributed evenly for the various components of that server. But in 2020, the major part was covered by the server. Means servers are mostly having, they are contributing in the carbon CO2 emission. So we have to control that. So this is the carbon footprint calculation for the telecom industry. So in telecom, actually, we are considering the mobile, the narrow bands, telecom devices, and the various broadbands. So in 2002, again, the most of the part was covered, the 43% for the mobiles. And now it has been extended from 43% to 51%. Means most of the each and every person is now what is having, and it is also responsible for the larger carbon CO2 emission. Now, so this was about the carbon footprint calculation in ICT or in telecom industries and the various data servers that are the part of the networking, because all these are connected through a network. Then how to achieve the sustainability? So how the green networking will be used to achieve the sustainability in the environment? So there are many ways to achieve the sustainability using the green networking. So the most important thing, we have to take care of the devices so that it can be used for many years. So how we can take care of that devices? So use your smartphone or other ICT devices longer before upgrading. Then make sure that the recycle and reuse the ICT equipment. Consume the digital services on smaller devices. Then charge the batteries with electricity from renewable resources. Avoid buying more ICT devices than you have time for. Pass the unused devices to someone else if you are not using that device. Show your suppliers that their footprint matters to you. And also buy your digital device and services from the companies that have SBT. So all these points are to be considered to achieve the sustainability using the green networking. So now this is showing just a graph how the total emission for the building and the transport is there. And that a green, that in that pie chart, that the green portion, it is showing the ICT enabled transport, how it is reducing the, how it is helping to have the sustainable environment. So in that to achieve the sustainable environment, it is considering the optimization of logistic networks, intermodal shift, optimization of collection or delivery, then optimization of route planning, eco-driving, reduction in necessary flight time, the in-flight fuel efficiency, reduction in ground level consumption, and then minimization of packaging. So all these are considered in case of the traffic, in case of building. So now I would like to conclude that how this green networking is helping in environmental and sustainability. So ICT sector has both a profitable opportunity and a critical role to play with other sectors to design and deploy solutions needed to create a low carbon society. So our focus is on improving the energy efficiency wherever possible, to collaborate with us in steering regulation to be more productive and to move boldly forward with technologies to improve our global climate. So acting now will be the good for business, good for economy, and good for the world. So like using green networking, it will be definitely possible to reduce the carbon emission in the environment, and also to help in sustainable the environment. Thank you.